टू मैनेज मीन्स टू ब्रिंग अबाउट टू अकम्प्लिश टू हैव चार्ज ऑफ और रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी फॉर एंड टू कंडक्ट लीडिंग अस इन्फ्लुएंसिंग गाइडिंग इन डायरेक्शन कोर्स एक्शन ओपिनियन वार्म वेलकम टू ऑल दिस इज अगल्या फ्रॉम डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ फूड सर्विस मैनेजमेंट एंड डायटेटिक्स कावेरी कॉलेज फॉर विमेन ऑटोनॉमस त्रिची टूडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द इम्पॉर्टेंस ऑफ लीडरशिप एंड द क्वालिटीज ऑफ गुड लीडर Leadership is described as personal quality of an individual that influences the behavior of followers. It is an important function of management. Let us know the definition of leadership. According to Coons and O'Donnell, leadership is the ability of a manager to induce subordinate to work with confidence and zeal. According to Tubin, leadership is the exercise of authority and decision making. Let us discuss about the importance of leadership. Leadership is important in view of the following reasons. To have teamwork, to guide, to motivate, to bring about changes, and to handle crises. To have teamwork. Leadership makes it possible for the employees to forget their individual differences and work as a teamwork for the attainment of the organizational objectives. It develops cooperation and friendliness among the staff. To guide. Although the subordinates have potential, they need to be properly guided to contribute their best. The leader knows how to get optimum performance from each of the subordinate working under him. To motivate. Leadership is necessary to induce the subordinate to put in greater efforts. The leader constantly motivates its subordinates in work for activating the organizational goals. To bring about changes. Any organization has to be dynamic to accelerate change caused by political, economic, technological and scientific factors. The leader of the organization knows how to bring about such changes in this organization by getting the consent of the subordinate staff. To handle crises. Leadership is essential for handling crises of any kind. When an organization faces a critical situation, the leader knows how to come out of it. The leader should be good at what is called as crisis management. Next, let us look into the essential qualities of leaders. Personal qualities. Self-confidence, dynamic personality, intellectual capacity, take lead and initiative, emotional stability, flexibility, responsibility feeling, communication skill, and foresightedness. These are all the qualities should be possessed by a good leader. Self-confidence. A good leader must have self-confidence, must have sufficient enthusiasm, and must be cheerful enough to enjoy the trust of his subordinates. Dynamic personality. A leader should be dynamic, cheerful and charming, must have sound health, cool temperament, conversational ability and decent behavior with tremendous stamina and vigor for hard work. Intellectual capacity. A leader should have the ability to think logically, analyze accurately and interpret the problems clearly. Take lead and initiative. A leader should have the ability to take lead and initiative in times of risk, uncertainties and complexities for prompt decision. Emotional stability. A leader should have balanced temperament to overcome moodiness, disappointment and inconsistency. Flexibility. A leader should be flexible enough to accommodate others' viewpoint and alter his decisions. Rigidity is only in autocracy. Changing decisions must be made with changing macro and micro environment. Responsibility feeling. A leader must feel or should bear responsibilities of all his decisions himself. Communication skill. The leader must be able to communicate with subordinates. The leader must communicate the information from his to the down level. Communication must be two-way so that both leader and subordinates will exchange ideas freely. for sightedness. The leader should develop organizational planning and policies. When the leader is not foresighted, all efforts may be worthless. Next, coming to the managerial qualities. Technical knowledge, organizing abilities, power of judgment, enthusiasm, ability to guide and teach, and human relation. Technical knowledge. A leader must have technical knowledge to provide the guidelines about the work of subordinates, which help the leader to take right decisions at right time. Organizing abilities. All the resources, employees, people, business environment, methods, capital, manpower should be arranged properly by a leader to achieve organizational goals in a proper way. Power of judgment. A leader should have the power of judgment, which comes from self-confidence and self-control. Even if there are several decisions, the leader must judge and decide the case. Enthusiasm. The leader must be devoted towards the organization. A devoted leader can conduct the activities successfully. Ability to guide and teach. It is the task of leader to get the best from others. A leader must know how to guide and teach the followers to make them convinced. Human relation. Leadership is related to inspire and encourage the people when there is good relation between leader and follower. The followers are easily influenced. So, a leader must be able to win the confidence and loyalty of a people. Thank you.